Welcome in the 7th game of the World Chess Championship Match 2018. And the players change colors here, and white start, and Carlsen started with the white pieces again. And Caruana had two blacks in game 6 and game 7. And now Carlsen went again with this d4 move, as he played in second game, knight to f6, knight f3, d5, c4, e6, and we have queen's gambit decline. Knight to c3, bishop e7, bishop f4. We are following the second game, short castling e3, c5, d takes c5, and of course you can see more analysis there in the second game about the opening moves. Bishop takes c5, queen c2, knight c6, a3 again, queen a5, and now Carlsen deviated first. In the second match, he played this move rook d1, and after rook d8, Caruana managed to equalize easily. But here, after knight to d2, he's threatening something. For example, if black play a random move like that, h6, then white can play knight to b3, attacking the queen and the bishop. And after this only move, queen b6, white can win by knight a4. And he's attacking the queen, and he's attacking twice the bishop. So black cannot do anything in order to protect this bishop, and white is totally winning. And if here, another point behind this knight d2 move is to recapture on c5 with the knight. For example, after d takes c4, then white can recapture with the knight, and this knight on c4 is powerful. I play Catalan, and I know that this knight is really strong there. I felt it when I played this system, and if you don't play this opening system with d4, then you cannot feel it very much. But this knight is very strong because it's protecting e5, he's targeting b6, targeting the queen, of course, protect b2. It's a powerful and very strong knight. The most popular move in this position is knight to e7, but Caruana came with another surprise. Of course, Carlsen know that this move is existed, but it wasn't in his first choices of analyze. Now, knight to b3, and here, please take a look that bishop to e7 is not a very good move, because after rook d1, we have some difficulties to find a good square for the queen, because queen doesn't have any good square here, and the d5 pawn is under attack. For that reason, Carlsen played this very nice move, bishop to b6. Caruana with black pieces played this very nice move, bishop to b6, in order to keep free the a7 square for the queen. And now, after long castling, this is a normal continuation, but it's a little scary because these files can be open, the c pawns will exchange soon, and it's a little dangerous to play the king on c1. Another normal continuation here is to play, of course, the rook on d1, because we are putting pressure on d5, and black should play this move queen 7, and you should be extremely careful with white, because white didn't finalize the development. For example, after c takes d5, he takes d5, knight takes d5, knight takes d5, rook takes d5, white is a pawn up, but now it's black's turn. And after bishop to e6, we are attacking the rook. The rook, for example, can go back, bishop takes b3, queen takes b3, everything is very forced. And after this check on a5, you start realizing that white have really real problems here. He cannot do anything good because his king is in the center, and black have compensation for the sacrificed pawn. Actually, he had the attack for the sacrificed pawn. And another continuation here, it's probably c5. You may wonder, why not? I'm attacking the bishop. Bishop c7, bishop takes c7, queen c7, knight b5, I'm attacking the queen, and for example queen e7, and again knight to d6, the octopus knight, right? But actually this knight is an empty knight in the center of the board. It doesn't generate any threats, any real play, because it doesn't cooperate with the rest of the pieces. And this is not a strength, but a weakness. And after b6, black may think that this knight is really poor, and he would like to capture or trap this knight somehow. It's not falling, the position is approximately equal, but it can create problems in long term to white. For that reason, c5 is not recommendable, and Carlsen thought about long castling, of course, and rook d1, and he just continued his development. A very normal move, bishop to e2, very nice. Queen e7, bishop g5, and now d takes c4. Knight d2 back in order to recapture with a strong knight, and knight e5. And now this is a critical position because white have a lot of choices. Here, of course, you can pause the video and try to think. And during the game he just castling, but other possible moves was f4. This is a very risky move, but of course it's playable. And another very strong move is knight c to e4. The idea behind it is after development, for example, you can play queen to c3, and now after this exchange, knight the bishop should not capture on e7. This is wrong because black can recapture on c3, and after bishop takes f8, knight takes e2, king takes e2, bishop, rook takes f8, and now black has two bishops and a pawn for a rook, and he's definitely better. This is not something good for a white player, but he can recapture on e4, and now after f6 we have an amazing move, a very nice move, and this move is queen takes e5, and of course it's very bad to capture the queen because after bishop takes e7, white is a piece up. For that reason he should recapture on g5, and now white can capture on c4, and this position is double edged because you can see here white have active pieces. All of these pieces are very active. He can castling short side very soon. The pawn on e7 is weak. These g pawns are doubled, but black have his own pawns in his position. He has the bishop pair. At some point he can put the bishop on c6. His pieces are active as well, and the f2 pawn is a weakness as well. So the position is approximately equal with double edge and playable for both sides. And if Carlsen would like to push a little more, this is a way to go. But during the game he didn't play that one, he just castling short, and now bishop to d7, bishop f4, knight g6, bishop g3, bishop c6, both players develop their pieces, knight takes c4, and everything is close to equal now. Bishop to bishop c7, rook f d1. Both players played good moves, but they cannot do anything in order to claim the advantage. Rook fd8, rook takes d8, rook takes d8, rook d1, another exchange on d1, queen takes d1, knight d5, aiming for more exchanges, queen d4, knight takes e3, queen takes e3, bishop takes g3, h takes g3, queen d7, gaining the file, bishop to d3. And after b6 we can see that white have this double pawns on the g line, but black cannot really take advantage of it. And now he played f3, a nice move, try to blockade this or to limit this c6 bishop. We have bishop to c7, and now another exchange, he captured on g6, h takes g6, and it's really not easy to do anything with white pieces. And we have e4 now, queen c7, e5, try to create this grip on d6. And in this endgame with queens and light pieces, it's better to have the knight because the knight is cooperating better with the queen, but we doesn't have anything special here because after this check the king has to go in the corner on h1, and you can see that white pieces are not coordinated perfectly. He cannot activate the king, and after bishop to a6, knight d6, we have another exchange on c3, big takes c3, b6, f6, f4, king f8, king g1, king e7, king f2, king d7, king e3, and this is how the strong players are offering and draw. He played bishop to f1, king f2 because the pawn was under attack, bishop a6, and this is a draw offer, king e6, bishop f1, and this is how the strong players are agreed to a draw by repeating some moves. So I hope you enjoyed this game. The critical or the important moments was when Carlsen deviates from the second game. He played knight to d2. This is the first moment. The second moment is here. He could play rook d1, for example, but he just developed his pieces. And the other critical moment is over here. He just castling, but an interesting option was to play knight c to e4 with a very sharp, more sharp position with more imbalances. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'm glad to see you in the next one. All the best!